I would just love to be able to go and order my coffee and order my kai in any space and place that I go. That te reo Māori or basic understanding of te reo Māori is acceptable, is shared and is celebrated. That's what I hope the next 50 years brings for us, for me and for my tamariki.
More and more people are using te reo Māori, including TVNZ's newest weather presenter, Te Rauhiringa Brown.
E ngā mana, e ngā reo, no mai, welcome.
In fact, it's her first language, so it's no surprise that she shares her joy of being her authentic self on and off air.
So you're getting feedback not just about the use of te reo, but your appearance as well.
Has TVNZ no wardrobe sense? Presenters of late are so frumpy looking. How terrible. Man, Polynesian Māori bodies are curvy, they're beautiful. It doesn't faze me. I love my big thighs. I will not watch the news anymore on One, as I am sick of having te reo Māori shoved down my throat.
How does reading something like that make you feel?
Of anything, it motivates me to use more te reo. We're trying to revitalise a language that was stripped away by the New Zealand government. And our Pākehā ancestors, your ancestors, and our Māori ancestors signed a document agreeing to protect te reo Māori, Article 2. In the English and the Māori, what we're doing is, it's not just for Māori, but it's for everybody.
For everyone.
It's for everyone. When I have a shift, I'll come in at lunchtime here in makeup. So te reo Māori, not only does it keep me grounded, because I get really, really nervous, it's live TV, and not only am I getting to promote, celebrate and normalise te reo Māori, but it's a cool way of mixing up different ways of describing the weather.
He ata ka puapua ki Tauranga Moana a Pōpō. Expect another grey day for Tauranga Moana. Ka ua ko patapata hoki, a bit of light rain from late in the afternoon.
Yeah, so it's a rule of mine to make sure that every single place name that I say in my broadcast, the Māori name is there as well. Westport, Kawatiri, Milford Sound, Pio Pio Tahi, yeah, he mea hou, e nei kupu katoa ki au.
And you're getting to share them with the rest of the nation who possibly have never heard them before.
Hei a pōpō, ka uapu kohu kohu ki te Tainawhiti, a few showers for the East Coast, that rain looking a bit more persistent.
I do enjoy how it's a conversation starter. It is an absolute conversation starter. This year, 50 years since the delivery of the Te Reo Māori petition to Parliament. And so maybe this type of exposure will get people talking. Mm. Maybe it'll get them curious. You know, I teach te reo Māori in Hobsonville, and we've had a few people come through that wanted to learn because of the use of te reo in mainstream television. And it's not just me. You know, Melissa Stokes will speak Māori. Dan Corbett speaks Māori.
Beautifully.
You know, it's more and more common now to hear te reo across every single show. My 7 and 8-year-old, 7th generation Pākehā, we'll see your presentation as a direct extension of the way te reo is incorporated in every part of their school life. Your style and language and mix of languages is our future. Yeah, no, that makes my heart just...
Yeah, that gave me the warm fuzzies too.
You may know. Heart explosions! Hei kōrero whakakapi pia. Some words of encouragement for te wiki o te reo Māori in celebration of the 50th anniversary of the Māori language petition. Ka taea te whakatika te reo hapa heoi, te taea te whakatika te reo ngū. So this whakatauki talks about just being brave, giving it a go, tuku nā te reo kia rere. Regardless, if you make mistakes, you can fix mistakes, but if you don't say anything, then yeah, you won't be able to learn and to grow. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koe.
Tēnā koe, Māori ora.
Tēnā koutou, mau I hono. Mai, thank you for joining. Pō mārie. Good night.